In this video, we are continuing to study the differential kinematics problem. So for today, we are going to focus on acceleration analysis. First of all, we are going to explain a review of all these kinematics analysis. Suppose that you have a serial robots with n degrees of freedom and m specific coordinates for the n effector robot. When we start the kinematics analysis, we start with the position problem. In position problem, you need to relate the n effector position and the joint positions. And the first study is with the forward kinematics model that's received as an input the joint position in order to obtain the n effector position. And in inverse forms, we have the inverse kinematics problem. So now you receive as an input the n effector position in order to obtain the joint positions. Now, for velocity, now we need to relate the joint velocities with the n effector velocities. We have the direct velocity using the Jacobian matrix that is mapping the joint velocities with the n effector velocities. And for the inverse velocity, we need to use the inverse Jacobian matrix if and only if we have the same number for n and m. That is that we have the same degree of freedom with the n effector coordinates. So if we have this case, it's possible now to obtain the joint velocities is you receive as an input the n effector velocities. And then for today, we have the acceleration analysis. The idea is to relate now the accelerations between the joints and the n effectors acceleration. We have the same problem for a direct problem and also an inverse problem, assuming also we have the same number for n and m. In some books, also they studied the so-called jerk analysis. That is an analysis that relates the derivative of the accelerations, but in this course is not include that study. Now, let's start with the direct accelerations. In direct accelerations, remember that you need to obtain the acceleration to the n effectors given the acceleration of the joints. So in this case, let's start with the direct velocity model. This is our mathematical equation. And then we are going to apply the derivatives in both sides of this equation. And then we obtain the direct acceleration model. In this case, you need to obtain the temporal derivative of the Jacobian matrix times the joint velocities plus the Jacobian matrix times the joint accelerations in order to obtain the n effector acceleration. Now, for the inverse acceleration, in this case, the idea is to obtain a set of solutions for the joint acceleration given and desired n effector accelerations. Again, we start with the inverse velocity model that include the Jacobian inverse matrix, and then we apply the temporal derivative in both sides of this equation, obtaining this final direct acceleration model. In this formulation, we need to obtain the temporal derivative of the inverse Jacobian matrix times the n effector velocity plus the inverse Jacobian matrix times the n effector accelerations in order to obtain the joint accelerations. In a block diagram, it's possible to have a graphic view how we are going to relate this direct and inverse acceleration. For a direct acceleration, So you need to receive as an input the joint velocities, joint accelerations, and with the Jacobian matrix and its derivatives, we can obtain the n effector accelerations. In other hand, we have that for the inverse model. Now, you need to receive as an input the n effector velocity, n effector acceleration, and with the inverse Jacobian matrix and its derivative, it's also possible to obtain the joint acceleration if and only if, remember that we had the same numbers of degrees of freedom with the n effector coordinates. Now, as an example of what is important to study the kinematics problem, suppose that we have a robot that needs to follow a specific trajectory. In industrial application, we have two types of trajectories, the so-called pick and place operation, where you need to start in an initial point and then finish in a desired point. The trajectory is open as you wish, as long as you don't have any collisions and also accomplish the task to move from this initial position to the desired position. But there are another kind of trajectories, the so-called continuous path trajectories, where you need to move from initial point to the desired point, but you need to follow a specific trajectory. In this case, we have a rectilinear trajectory. Any of this case is possible to accomplish if we use a control system that, at the beginning of this control system, you need to solve the inverse kinematics model and also the trajectory generator. Both of them come from the kinematics analysis. In one of them, you need to transform the n effector coordinates to the joints values, and then the trajectory generator is going to generate the plots for the position, velocity, and accelerations for these joints variables. That is going to be the inputs for the control system. That is something that we are going to see in next videos. Here we have an example. What is the result if we have a pick and place trajectory, in this case for a planar robot with 2 degrees of freedom, and we have the plots here for the first and second joints for the position, velocity, and acceleration graphics of this robot. When you move this effector to this position, initial position, to the final position. Here we have a continuous path trajectory for the same robot, where you need to move from here to here, but you need to follow a rectilinear trajectory. In this case, also we have these plots for the two joints for position, velocity, acceleration. As you can see here, we have a different plots compared to the pick and place operation. And also, this is a previous study to the dynamics analysis.